heads figuratively in Las Vegas, but don't want to lose it literally. As we come alongside the beautiful Luxor, which is going to be coming up eventually. Right along on your right-hand side, you'll see the hieroglyphics on the side of the Luxor. Now, they're actually explaining some gambling terms to people, and they're telling the king about the hand when you get 17 in your blackjack hand. It's called the mother-in-law hand because you want to hit it, but you shouldn't. You're very welcome. Of course, the Luxor is an amazing property. The pyramid itself is known as the world's largest open and closed space. That sounds very odd until you consider it like this. If you take 9 747s and stack them on top of each other inside of the Luxor, they do not touch the walls at any point. So that's a pretty big open space, but it's enclosed. So that's what it's all about. Now we can really see the light at the top of the Luxor. And I was telling our folks that we're already on board from Circus Circus, that is one of few things that can actually be seen but from space. There are only three. You can see the Grand Canyon, you can see the Great Wall of China, and you can see the light at the top of the Luxor. I can see that where I live on the west side of Las Vegas from my house as well. Now they had to tone it down. It's at 315,000 watts of power, but it was closer to 500,000 watts of power. But they had to tone it down because it was blinding the pilots when they were coming into McCarran Airport. So that's pretty darn bright. There are dozens of xenon lights up there, and each one of them costs $1,200. They do last for 2,000 hours. As you can see, the Luxor is joined to Mandalay Bay by the monorail, as well as Excalibur. All three of them are connected. The hotel is the great big angled hotel that's currently on your right-hand side. That is part of Mandalay Bay. That's an all-suite property.
Sweet.
And inside of Mandalay Bay, there is another property. It's known as the Four Seasons. The Four Seasons has its own special check-in and check-out and an express elevator all the way up to the top. Needless to say, that's where the rich and famous stay, so they don't have to deal with us. Also, at the Mandalay Bay, that's where you can go and explore a sunken ship that's in the aquarium. It's quite the aquarium, I'll tell you, too, because that is the world's largest predator-based aquarium. It's filled with sharks with big pointy teeth and piranhas. Man-eating squid. And you can explore a ship in there if you want to. Nah, they wall off the big scary sharks. They say that you get to swim with harmless sharks. I didn't know there was such a thing. Now, in case you're wondering why would someone bring their scuba gear all the way out to the desert, they're cruising back. Because that Boulder Dam, when they built the Hoover Dam, they wanted it. Mandalay Bay is attached to the convention center. One of three very large convention centers that are here on the Strip area. Mandalay Bay, there's also the Las Vegas Convention Center, which is over by the Hilton. And the other one, which you'll see, is on the Sands, which is attached to the Palazzo. All in all, we have 12 million square feet of convention space here in Las Vegas. On its own, and that's the World Market Center, which is in the downtown section. Now we're coming up to the sign. We're going to be coming up the back side of the sign, where it's going to say you are now leaving Las Vegas. Strangely enough, you're not really in Las Vegas. You're actually in the little township of Paradise, very far from it. But this area is considered to be Paradise. It's the area up by Circus and Winchester. He does not speak English, he only speaks German, so he's not listening to me. very freaky. Going down the stairs. Okay, he's coming down. He's coming down the stairs on me, Jose. All right. Okay. You can go down now. All right, anyway, if you'd like to take some pictures of the sign, we'll stop here for a few minutes so you can take some pictures. Because that seems to be the thing to do right now. So. Okay. But anyway, he can hear me. He just has no idea what I'm saying to him. He's just scaring me. All right. Anyway, this is a world-famous sign. And folks all over the world know what it is. It was given to the city of Las Vegas by its creator, Betty Willis, in 1959. You can go ahead and take some pictures of it if you want to. We'll stop here for a couple of minutes so you can take a couple of pictures. Yay! You know, I find that it actually comes out better during the day, though, than the evening. There's this, like, horrible glare that you get off of it during... Hello, Jose! Take it off. We can continue the route right now, so we can definitely make it down there on time. The man that doesn't speak English is scaring the life out of me, Jose. Alright.
Okay. Listen, folks.
I'm sorry?
After we stop the road.
Sometimes he's here. You're going to see when we get downtown.
We are going to have one now at the Golden Logan. I'm going to count how many people there are on the bus.
I want the same people, the same number coming back in 1 hour, 9 o'clock, okay?
Okay?
Okay. Don't take more than 1 hour because we leave you, folks, okay?
Do you know the difference between a tourist and a hitchhiker? 5 minutes. Oh, I love this joke. Yes, ma'am. Larev at 9:30. What about it? You want to go there? We don't do a hop-on, hop-off at this time. This is just actually a shuttle bus that we're just going straight downtown. This isn't a night. The night tour is not a hop-on, hop-off. No, we're not going to stop there. Are you supposed to go there this evening? For a second, I gotta show you something. Alright, he's gonna end up coming around the corner here. When you can't speak a bunch of languages, but anyway, we're on our way again, and as we come up the road here, soon to be coming up just past all these wonderful jets, this happens to be the section of the airport that's the executive section of the airport, so this is where we're going to be having Garth Brooks flying in with his lovely wife, Trisha Yearwood, very shortly, beginning of December. Yeah, I got crazy low flight. past this, but I really want to try and point out. I bet you she just got married at the little chapel of the west, which is going to be coming up on your right hand side. That little chapel has been there a very long time. Well, not at this exact spot. Actually, this is its third spot, but it's been here in Las Vegas since 1941. To let you know how many people have gotten married at this little chapel, Betty Grable, that's how old it is, got married at this little chapel. It'll be coming right up on your right hand side in the little clump of pine trees right on the right hand side. Not only did she get married there, but also 7 out of 8 times Mickey Rooney got married at this little chapel. 7 out of 8 times he got married at this cute little chapel. Also, Richard Gere, he got married here to Cindy Crawford. Angelina Jolie got married there, not to Brad Pitt though, she got married to Billy Bob Thornton. And of course, Elvis, he got married there to Anne Margaret in the movie Viva Las Vegas. Yeah, they never actually did get married. Oh, and don't worry, you haven't drunk too much. Right over here, there is a pink elephant, really there, honestly. Now back in the old days, though, these are the kind of motels and hotels we used to have. They didn't look like these amazing things like the Mandalay Bay. They were just little tiny places. Now that one still has some pretty good sized rooms. But the old ones, that's all of them, had these really small little rooms that the dog wandered in. He had to wag his tail up and down. There was no room for side to side. The mice were hunchbacked. It was just terrible. Now, from this point on, we're not allowed to put anything in very tall. Everything has to be low because of the airport. But we do have something big coming in. Right across from Mandalay Bay, there's going to be the Sky View, which is an observation wheel, very much like you'll see in London, like the London Eye. And it'll be coming up right past that bus that's ahead of us. They'll have cars that seat 25 people inside of the cars. Quite amazing. And you can get married on it if you want to. They say you should get married at the top because it's downhill all the way. I've had 2 failed marriages. My first husband left me, my second husband won't. I'm kidding, actually. I've been married most of my life. Going to be 29 years, for real, I'm going to be married this December.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I got that joke from my friend, Robert Allen. Right here at the Tropicana, as well as an episode of Charlie's Angels. We're still here with Dean Martin, one of my favorite Rat Pack members. Now, if you come right up to the corner here, you'll have a really good view of Lady Liberty. at New York, New York. And that's the one that's on the postage stamp. It's not the one, that's the one from New York City. You also have a good view, of course, of the fantastic roller coaster. It goes at 65 miles an hour, and it's meant to look just like Crazy Yellow Cab. When it first opened, they used to give you little checkered cab hats to wear. You better hang on to it when you go on that roller coaster, though. I had one. I wish I had hung on to it. Now, of course, looking over at the MGM Grand, the Singapore bronze statue of the lion was where the original entrance used to be, but it was a giant lion head. And you walk through the mouth of the lion to walk through into the casino. Well, there was a problem with that, and you people might be able to attest to this, because Asian folks supposedly don't like to walk through the mouth of a lion. Is that true? He said no. Well, that's the rumor. Anyway, it's supposedly bad luck, so they had a lot of folks that didn't want to walk through the mouth of the lion. I mean, I understand that. It does sound kind of scary. But when you walk through the mouth of the lion, when you got in there, it was all things Wizard of Oz. All the memorabilia from the movie was inside. The ruby slippers were inside there. And I thought it was fantastic. I had been through there myself. I went through it. And that's why it's all green like that, to look like the Emerald City from the Wizard of Oz. Wizard of Oz is definitely one of my favorite movies. And I don't know if you know this, but originally it wasn't Judy Garland that was supposed to be Dorothy. It was Shirley Temple. She was supposed to play Dorothy. Now, sitting right here at this corner, this has the highest concentration of rooms in the entire world. At this corner, we have 12,000 rooms between Tropicana and also Excalibur, New York, New York, and MGM. MGM itself has just under 7,000 rooms. We have about 150,000 rooms in the city of Las Vegas. Also at MGM, that's where you're going to be able to see the lion habitat. M&M's in colors that you never see anywhere else in the world. Silver, black, gold, silk, print. Images on them, pictures. So put sayings on them, whatever you want. We've done for you at the M&M store. And the Coca-Cola store, you can go in there too. And I found out that Coca-Cola doesn't taste the same all over the world. I didn't know that. I thought Coca-Cola was Coca-Cola. Also, there's the ABC store. Yay! There's a little joke we have between us. And soon to be coming also up on your right-hand side, we're going to see the Hawaiian Marketplace. Now, they have three shows there, starting at 2 o'clock in the afternoon and also again at 7 o'clock in the evening. They have some great bands that play there, including the Love Brothers, Cool Change, Ken and Tammy of Pentamination. And also, they have a wonderful Hawaiian cocktail place there as well, called Hot Lava. Hot Lava should be out there tonight, as a matter of fact, but I didn't see that. Anyone who loves good barbecue, Harley Davidson. If you like Harley Davidson for that matter. They actually have real motorcycles that go around the top of the room. Now, they're not turned on. They're on a conveyor belt on chains, and they go around. I had a man say to me, doesn't it get awfully smoky in there? They're not on. We're going to gas you out of the building. That would work out very well. But over on the right-hand side, now we're back up to the Miracle Mile shops. Miracle Mile shops, a mile and a half of shopping. And that, of course, is Planet Hollywood. And Planet Hollywood stands on the spot that used to be the Aladdin at one time. The old Aladdin, then new Aladdin, and now Planet Hollywood. The old Aladdin is a place that was owned at one time by Wayne Newton with his friend Ed Torres. Quite a few things to see. See the lights of Paris in front of us. See, this is the time to see it, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's cool during the day, but at night it's just... it's shiny. It's really shiny. you can see the lights on the inside is the chandelier inside of Cosmopolitan over on your left-hand side right now. You can see the chandelier pretty well. Three levels to that chandelier with three different bars inside of the chandelier. Of course, coming up to Bellagio. Now these fountains are going to be going off every 15 minutes here. And there they go. Perfect timing. As if I told them to do it. Isn't there something? Of course, we're going to be coming up to Bally's, which is going to be on your right hand side. Now, for now. Yay! As I was going to say though, over on our right hand side, Bally's. If you see Bally's during the day, it doesn't look that impressive, but in the evening it looks amazing. A few movies that were filmed at Bally's, Indecent Proposals one, with Demi Moore, Woody Harrelson, and of course Robert Redford. Yeah, right here at Bally's. Not only that, but also there's another movie that I really like, which is Honeymoon in Vegas. This is where the flying Elvis is landed. Yeah, right here. And Jubilee, this is Jubilee place here at Bally's. Jubilee, if you can look up at the very top, those type of showgirls. The fancy, fancy feathers. Topless except on Saturday evening at 7 o'clock. They're covered up a bit more, but children still have to be over 13 years old to see Jubilee here at Bally's. Looking down to your left-hand side, you'll see Rio. That's part of Harrah's Entertainment as well. That's where they have Carnival in the Sky, which is a free show to see, and they throw you beats and you don't have to show anything. That's good fun. Also, of course, the beautiful Flamingo. At one time was known as the Flamingo Hilton, and then before that, originally. It's been here a long time, but it wasn't always this big. Of course, getting a good look at Caesar's Palace. The four columns at the top is the original section of Caesar's Palace built in the late 60s. All the rest of it grew up around it. The two towers that face Flamingo, that's the newest section. Well, that doesn't sound like the Margaritaville song. I love it. I want some more of it. Of course, Harrah's, that's one of my favorites. I love Mac King right there at the top of this fishbowl. 1 and 3 o'clock in the afternoon. That's a great show. He incorporates the audience into the show, so it's different every single time. I've seen him no less than 6 times, and he cracks me up every single time. I love that show. He's one of my favorites, definitely. Of course, the Mirage. The Mirage is where you'll find Siegfried and Roy's Tiger. Speaking of Siegfried and Roy, also 2 brand new baby dolphins. Yeah, they're Daddy Lightning. Oh, and here's where you get some deals over here at Casino Royale. 99 cent frozen margaritas, $1.99 hot dogs. One of the few places you can do that on the strip. You can do that downtown though, all over the place. Way more inexpensive downtown. Waiting to see if we're going to see maybe one of these volcanoes erupt on us. That's over at the Mirage as well. So, of course, the Venetian is where you'll ride those gondolas through the streets of Venice. And this is where they have the coolest wax museum on the planet, Madame Tussauds, here at the Venetian. An interactive wax museum. You can pretend you're getting married to George Clooney, if you like. Yeah. Not only that, but if, for the guys, if you ever wanted to pinch the halo on the bottom, you can do that if you want. Yeah, at the wax museum. Oh, here's the beautiful Palazzo. As I said, attached to the Venetian, so you can go from one to the next. Palazzo stands on the spot that used to be the Sands. The Sands, of course, most known for where the Rat Pack used to play. Out front of it, the Sands, it used to say, starring Frank Sinatra. Sometimes Dean, sometimes Sammy. Never knew who was going to show up. Of course, you have beautiful Treasure Island across the way. 7:30. Yeah, but they change them. Sometimes once it's, you know, they'll start them earlier. Now they turn the clock back. They might have started it a bit earlier. They'll tell you if you call them up. They change them all the time when they change the times on us. It looked like folks were lining up on our way down, so I think it was earlier today. Treasure Island, of course, being one time a Steve Wynn property. And speaking of Steve Wynn, we're going to let you off right ahead in a little bit. Yeah. You want him to go down now? Okay, he'll let you off right now. That Russian lady wanted to go and see something at the Wynn, and she didn't realize that wasn't going to happen this time. So, all right. She's got her downstairs, so then when we get up to the Wynn, we can just drop her off. I don't have my bus legs. I'm going to be a good surfer. That's going to end up happening from this. We're coming up to the downstairs right now. And the F-plane shop is going off the No one but Jose would do this. That's just how great he is. Yay, Jose! They're clapping for you! Across the street, of course, the Fashion Show Mall. And as they're showing you, the live fashion shows here. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, live fashion shows at the Fashion Show Mall. 250 shops in size, and that is the second largest mall in the United States. Win an Encore. 5-star resort, most expensive on the strip. And we're going to show you where Wynn got this big start when he started, because we're going to the Golden Nugget. That's where he started here in Las Vegas. He started out as a pit boss and ended up buying the building. Actually, he got his start when he was a youngster. His father was in the bingo business, and he was a bingo caller. That's how he got started. He said that he never would have ended up in Las Vegas had his father not died when he was a younger man, because his father didn't want him to come to Las Vegas. His father actually was a bit of a problem gambler and was worried that he would get bit by the bug as well. And he got bit by the real estate bug instead. Doing pretty darn well for himself, I have to say. Of course, you see where it says Wynn, that's his signature, and the dot at the end, that's because his real name is Weinberg. I see it. That's his real name. It's Steven Weinberg. Now, there is an exact duplicate of this property in Macau, China. Now you don't have to go there. Yeah, the Solo Beach, that's a Cowboys beach. I doubt today, though. Yeah, a little cold today for that. Unless you're from Alaska, I think the weather's a little chilly for bathing beauty to be out in. And there's a picture of Steve Wynn, with old blue eyes himself. And speaking of eyes, though, Steve Wynn is actually going blind. He's got a condition known as retinitis pigmentosus. So I think that's why he didn't design something incredibly different for Macau, because he was really unable to see what he was doing. So he just said, well, I like that one a lot. Let's just put that one there. Same thing. Oh, coming up, if you look over, you can see the hill. This Hilton fan over on the right-hand side. Well, that, of course, was the International, and that's where Elvis Presley played. And that 50% of everyone visiting Las Vegas back in the day when he was playing, they were here just to see Elvis before, but nothing else. Now they say he haunts the show for people. They say that you'll find him sometimes, you'll see his ghost standing on the stage, or sometimes he likes to hang out around the green room area. Now if you go over there and you see something that looks exactly like Elvis, don't worry too much, because it could very well be Trent Carlini. He's the world's best Elvis impersonator, and he is actually performing right now at the Hilton. So you can see the next best thing to the real live Elvis over at the Hilton. And looking at something that's not real live, but really a treat, we have the Crazy Girls. Five bronze beauties with very shiny butts. And the reason their butts are so shiny is you rub their butts and you get good luck. Riviera has some great memorabilia since it's been there since 1955. And inside you'll see pictures of Elvis with Liberace actually working together, which is pretty darn cool. And the funny thing is you have Elvis sitting at the piano and Liberace is playing the guitar. It was Elvis that had, Elvis was the one that got taught how to slam up his act by Liberace. So he started wearing those sparkly jumpsuits. Now, of course, if you're wondering what in the world this is, that's the Fontainebleau. That's meant to be a sister property to Fontainebleau in Miami. However, that $2.9 billion venture failed due to the economy. It has been purchased, however, by Carol Icahn for 10 cents on the dollar. All of the furnishings that were meant to go into the Fontainebleau ended up downtown at the Plaza. The Plaza is one of my favorite properties. They just redid the whole inside of it, and you can get $5 free slot play if you sign up for the card, the Vegas Club card, which is just right across the street from the Golden Nugget as well. Now coming up to the Sahara. Well, a couple of nights ago, they had the lights on the dome, because that has been purchased as well, and they're going to start refurbishing it, which is really cool. That has a lot of history to it as well. As a matter of fact, that's where the Fab Four, the Beatles, played. Back in 1964, they stayed at the Sahara, all the way up at the top floor in the Ambassador's Suite, but the girls found out where they were staying, so they all booked the floor right below. That caused a little bit of trouble. They were actually climbing the walls of the building to try and get up to see the Beatles. Well, the police got a little upset with them and told them if they continued their shenanigans, they were all going to end up in juvenile hall. So they stopped doing that, thank heaven. So the Sahara had some great memorabilia. They sold off all the memorabilia and they paid off the entire property. The mortgage has been paid off in its entirety, and they're ready to get started on working on the Sahara again. Of course, the world's largest gift shop is, and if it's in stock, they have it. So, that's right off the wall. Now we're coming up to my favorite, the Stratosphere. That is the fifth largest structure in the United States. It is the largest west of the Mississippi at 1,149 feet. You can jump off, but you really can't. It's controlled free fall. There's where it looks like a blue plank sticking out. Well, that's where they launch you off, and you come all the way down. You're not coming quite from the very top, so it's not quite the 1,149 feet. But you will land right on that red ridge right there where the lights are going around on the bottom. That's where they let you fall to. It's pretty cool. I would do it. No? I did the thing at the top. shot. That's the world's tallest thrill ride. It was very thrilling. Once they shot me up into the air, I could actually see the pilot's face. I was waving right at him from the helicopter. Hi! That was a blast. I would do that again. That was so much fun. But I would not do a screamer insanity, because I used to work in amusement parks, you know, and I know which rides fail and which ones don't. Roller coasters fail all the time, and Insanity is kind of a roller coaster. It's like a roller coaster car on a track. That's terrifying, because then it just teeters over the edge, and Extreme is on this side here, and it looks like an arm that comes over the side with five little cars attached to the fingers, and you're facing like this, spinning round and round. That one would make me execute. I don't want to go on it. That one frightens the life out of me. Now, coming up, something really cool, though, too. On the left-hand side, we're coming up to the White Cross Drugstore. The Rat Pack used to hang out there. It has the old-fashioned grill where you can get yourself a hamburger or a cheeseburger or malted. And they have all kinds of Rat Pack memorabilia also inside the White Cross Drugstore right over here on your left-hand side. And we're coming up to Chapel Row as well. Now this has a lot of the freestanding wedding chapels. In Las Vegas, we actually have more churches than anywhere else on earth, because we have so many wedding chapels. And as many of them, we have these cute little ones like this one right over here, the Chapel of the Flowers, which is adorable. In all of the big properties, we have wedding chapels as well. That way people don't have to wait too long to start the honeymoon. We're gonna be coming up to the small Las Vegas sign on your left-hand side, and you'll see the Welcome to Downtown Las Vegas sign. That looks exactly like the great big one. It's only a quarter of the size of that one, though. Again, though, designed by Betty Willis, of course. And right after that, we're going to be coming up to a very famous wedding chapel as well. That will be on the right-hand side, right past Howard Johnson. You're going to see the little white chapel. And that's where Frank Sinatra married Mia Farrow when she was only 21 and he was like 50. And that'll be coming up just on the right-hand side. Also, Michael Jordan got married there, and Joan Collins got married there. And I received my vows there. And the lady that owns it is pretty cool. I would have thought that she never would have been interested in having a wedding chapel business, that she was abandoned by her first husband here in Las Vegas. Yeah? And now she's an ordained minister. And if you want to get married and fast, they have a drive-through wedding window, so you don't even have to get out of the car. That's a little white chapel on your right-hand side. But on your left-hand side, the talk of the town, well, that place over there, that's one was featured also in the movie Hangover. So that's right over there. Right there. Right there with the passage. Because, like, they're right on top of each other. One's on the right side, one's on the left side. There it is. Those models, like, or the ladies that are mannequins are sitting on the swings. It kind of gives me the creeps. Alright, now if you want to get married by Elvis, or if you want to get married by Mr. Spock, you can do that at the Viva Las Vegas Wedding Chapel. And we're going to be coming up, of course, to the Pawn Star Pawn Shop, too. You're going to be seeing that over on your right-hand side very, very shortly. And they also have this great little place that I really like called the Verdict Inn. They're only open in the afternoon, but they have the world's best bread pudding. You ever see the movie When Harry Met Sally? I looked like Sally when I had the bread pudding. That good! Awesome. Well, they also have some great sandwiches and things, but the bread pudding is just the best I've ever had in my life. Does anybody watch the Pawn Stars Pawn Shop show? You do? Yeah, there you go, right by it. Did you guys see it on the blue tour? Did you do that today? You did? Yeah. Did you go in? Oh, you didn't go in? Was the line crazy?
Yeah.
You know, it's amazing how many people wait to get into that shop. I mean, the one day we were going by, and literally the line came out the door and around the corner all the way up to the telephone pole. It was nuts. I don't think they need to sell any of the things they buy now. They just sell so many t-shirts and shot glasses and things like that out of there. It's so easy to have to sell. It's a wonderful item. I just passed Cupid's Wedding Chapel on the same side of the street. That's where the place is if you want to come down here tomorrow and get some bread pudding at the Verdict Inn. It's called the Verdict Inn because, of course, this area has lots of courthouses and we have lots of bail bonds people. I don't know why, but people come here to Las Vegas and never come. Never the people that are right in our hotel. No. Those other people. Yeah. And here we come to the Pawn Stars Pawn Shop. board, but not necessarily inside of it. Some walk-up window that's open 24 hours. We will close the inside of it. We're going to be heading up the road. We're going to be seeing the gay caballero, the horse and rider coming up right in front of us. Now, he used to be at the hacienda. The hacienda used to be where Mandalay Bay now is. He'll be coming up on your left-hand side. Before we get there, over on your right-hand side right now, that's the federal building. That's where Senator Harry Reid has his office. And on your left-hand side, the little white building over here, that was the first elementary school in Las Vegas. Down to Arts and Crafts Center. So rather than teaching you your ABCs, they teach you how to compete in commerce. I can start to see the hacienda rider twinkling ahead of us on the left. The Wee Kirk of the Heather is on the right-hand side, and that little wedding chapel says it's actually 1 year older than the Little Chapel of the West. The Little Chapel of the West was 1941. This one's been here since 1940, and because he stayed over here in this area of town, he didn't have to be picked up and moved over and over and over again. And I'll tell you something, if you want to go to a concert, it's not going to, you know, captivate mine for you. We got several of them out here. They weren't seen on TV. The first elevator, all of it, down here. This is the real area. Huh. And we'll see the first modern casino, the El Cortez. This is Ben Siegel had his first place. There's a lot of refurbishment that's happening in the downtown area. And one of the newest ones that's going to be happening is right in front of us and to the right-hand side. That's the Lady Luck. And the Lady Luck has been closed for 6 years. However, it has been purchased by the Sim Group out of Hollywood, California. They're going to take $100 million into that old lady. They're going to restore her to her former glory. His start when he was only 15 years old, and he had to come through the kitchen. He couldn't come through the front doors because he was only 15. He couldn't come through the casino. He used to do 6 45-minute sets a day when he was a young man working here at the Fremont Hotel. Now over on the right-hand side, this is where you can get your picture taken at Binion's with a million dollars, and there'll be a picture right on the wall, right on your right-hand side. It doesn't cost anything, but it does take 30 minutes for that to print out. And we're coming under the Fremont. Now, it is crazy down here. I'm warning you, people. It's nuts. No, us locals, we love it here. This is where we always like to come and party, too. So a lot of the people that are out here aren't even tourists. They live here. We just love it so much on Fremont Street. Of course, this is the canopy right above our heads here. that goes off hourly on the hour. Only lasts for a few minutes though. And they'll do it again every hour. That is 15 million LED lights, 550,000 watts of sound. And this is the Golden Nugget. We're going to be stopping right over here. We'll come around the block and stop right over here. This is, as I said, this was Stephen's first place. And it's known as the Jewel of Glitter Gold. They don't trust your credit, though. You have to put actual cash into that ATM to get the gold and get the gold in that credit card. That's there. Oh, also, the Golden Nugget, known as the Hand of Fate. Looks like it's giving you the Boy Scout symbol. It's known as the Hand of Fate. It is over 61 pounds of gold in one single nugget. It was found in Australia at the Golden Triangle. Only 6 inches below the ground. Here and I'll take you right out with me. I'll go along with you out to the Fremont Street Experience. And this is where we'll pick you up. Remember, we're only allowed to stay here for an hour.
We made it. Oh, I almost froze to death.